Hey everyone, it's your boy, the Workout Geek, and it's finally here. My review of the Fostex T20 RP headphones. It took a little bit longer than what I had planned, and if you guys have been following my channel, you know that in between the unboxing of these headphones and now the review, I've got I did so many other unboxings, and I was getting different ear pads for these headphones, which kind of made the review drag out a little bit longer. And so that's pretty much the whole thing why it took too long. I just got so many unboxings I had to do, and then got called into work, and now I'm not working again. So I had a little bit more time to finally get this review out. So before we start this review, let's just get this disclaimer out of the way. I am an Amazon associate or Amazon affiliate. So if you guys are interested in these headphones and you use the link in my description, it does help out my channel and help me give to my charity of choice on Amazon. That's the Wounded Warrior Project. And also to help me in the future make better content for you guys. About a month ago, maybe more than a month, almost 2 months now, since I got these headphones on Amazon with Prime shipping. And during my unboxing, I had mentioned to you guys that one of my goals in this headphone beginning enthusiast hobby or whatever is to own an open back headphone and also a planar magnetic headphone, which the Fostex have fulfilled. So this is the third iteration of their RP headphones. RP stands for regular phase, which is Fostex's version of planar magnetics. You can also say orthodynamic headphones. And the way I decided on the T20 was that when you look on Amazon's website or even Fostex, if you get these on Fostex's website, you won't even find it in the consumer headphones or consumer products section. You'll find it in the professional products section. And like I said, there's three of them. The T20 right here, the T30, and the T50. And so this is the way Fostex and Amazon has it on their page. The T20 are the open ones for deep bass. The T40 are closed for a focus based, and the T50 are semi-open for a flat and clear sound. But as you will see in other reviews, the way they're described was, this is the bassy one. The T50s are the more high-end or treble approach oriented, and the T40s are more neutral and closed. Now, if you guys are interested on getting these headphones, let's just make one thing perfectly clear. These headphones go for around anywhere, depending on the time that you go decide to get them. They can go anywhere from between 140 to like 160. I believe I got them, they were like 159.99. And these are planar magnetic headphones, so just like every other planar magnetic headphones, they are very hard to drive. It's funny because on Amazon and Fostex's website, they say, you know, what's included with it. It says it comes with a 3.5 mini cable for portable use. If you want to use this for portable use, you're going to have to invest in a portable amp or amp DAC, just like my Aimpire right here or the Monolith. And if you are interested in a portable amp DAC, you got to make sure it has enough power to drive these headphones at reasonable volumes or loud enough volumes for your listening enjoyment. Another thing you should be aware of before you get these headphones is that the stock ear pads are not really that good, even though Fostex says they are. So you're going to need to invest anywhere from like $20 up to over $50 on some good ear pads. So with a good headphone or portable amp DAC, like So the Monolith is one of the more pricier ones, but like say the Empire, you're looking at another $100 right there. There, I know there's some cheaper ones on the market, probably like around 50, that are pretty decent that could probably drive these headphones. But so you're looking at anywhere between 50 to over, if you go way overboard, over $300, unless you already have a portable amplifier or amp deck. But regardless, if you buy replacement pads or use the stock pads, you feel like they're comfortable enough for you, then you are getting a great set of headphones that sound really good. And like I said, the T20s right here are the ones that I chose because they offer the most bass. And for all you bass lovers out there, these are the headphones you're going to want to get if you listen to a lot of house, hip hop, new age music, even pop, rock, dance music. These are the headphones to get. And so that's pretty much it for my review. I'm just kidding. As you guys know, I like to go into detail with my reviews. And so for this review, there are going to be timestamps below on any of the sections that you want to maybe just skip forward to or are more interested in. This review is going to be broken down into the intro, which we already did, the overview, which is going to be a short, brief history about these Fostex headphones, and also why planar magnetic headphones. We're going to talk about the specs and also what's included in the box with these headphones, the hardware and build quality, the connectivity, and then we're going to go over the sound in detail. These headphones, as I mentioned, are planar magnetic headphones, or what Fostek calls their regular phase technology. They're also orthodynamic headphones. If you guys have never heard of Fostek, the company was founded in 1973 by Foster Electric Company. And Foster Electric was founded in 1949. And they're one of the world's largest developers of OEM speakers, transducer products, and things like that. So speakers, transducers, microphones, they make headphones, microphones, they make amplifiers. And so like I said, this is the third iteration. That's why it's called the MK3. The T20 RP, the first ever planar magnetic headphones ever produced, was in 1972, and it was they were called the Wharfedale ID1 isodynamic headphones, and then that was shortly followed in 1976 with Yamaha headphones, their HP1. And then shortly after, in 1977, Fostex came out with their version of the planar magnetic headphones. And back then it was the T10, the T20, the T30, and the T50. And as you guys can see from the older pictures, the T50 looks way different now than how it used to look when it first got released. I actually like the look of these old T50 headphones. They almost look open back. It looks like they got metallic grills on the outside of the headphones. Whereas the T20 is the only one of the original RP headphones that actually almost look the same. Like they didn't really change much in appearance. Right? And so the RP series of headphones from Fostex, or let's just say the T50, have gotten quite a like a cult following. As you guys have seen them in my unboxing, they are some of the most heavily modded headphones in the audio community. I usually liken them to your Honda Civics of the car world, where there's so many types of kits, so many types of different like designers making these Fostex or making modded headphones for sale. And if you go online or go on YouTube, you'll see all kinds of reviews on the T50s, not so much on the T20s. So that's another reason why I wanted to get these, because I wanted to find out for myself if they were, number one, if they sounded good, and number two, if they really did have enough bass. And based off of that, I could share my experiences on how these sound and what I think of the headphones. So YouTube, you're welcome. Okay, let's go over the specs on these headphones for all you spec junkies. So the T20RP, the T40RP, and the T50RP MK3, they all, I believe they all use the same driver. With the difference being, like I said, this is an open dynamic RP regular phase driver. It has a frequency response of 15 hertz to 35 kilohertz. It's got a resistance or impedance of 50 ohms. And 50 ohms might not seem like it's a very high number compared to, like, let's say 300 ohms. But believe me, you're still going to need a dedicated amp deck or a high-res music player with a good amp. It has a sensitivity of 92 decibels per milliwatt. Has a maximum input wattage of 3000. So that is a lot. Out of all the headphones, it probably has the most maximum input wattage. The Audio Technicas are the second, and those go up to like 1000 milliwattage of input. It comes with two cords. You have your 6.3 connector, 3 meters. What is 3 meters? 3 meters is like what? Like six and a half feet or 6.6 feet, something like that. And then it has another 3.5 connector, which you guys just saw, the orange one, with the 3.5 millimeter connector, and that's 1.2 meters or 3.5 feet. And that is it for specs. Okay, so now let's go through a little walkthrough and talk about build. The build quality on these T20s is going to be the same as your T40 and T50. So if you guys seen reviews on the T50s, usually they're going to have the same build quality. And they're very robust, even though, like, the outside part right here is mostly plastic. It seems like it's a thick plastic. And as you guys seen in my other reviews, I'm not going to knock them just because they're plastic. Because like I was saying in other reviews, some of your most durable equipment or some of your most durable things are made out of plastic, like bulletproof glass riot shields, the cases for your smartphones and electronic devices. And this is a very thick plastic. The headphone adjustment part right here is all metal. All metal. Don't know what kind of metal, but it's all metal, and it's very they're pretty thick. Someone said if the clamping force is too much, you could bend this metal. Good luck trying to bend it with your own hands, because they're probably going to be pretty hard. You're going to have to use some kind of a wrench or something to bend these things. And they have a, you know, they are the they have a detachable cable, as you can see. And a lot of reviews, people don't like these the out of the box detachable cables that these come with, but I kind of don't mind. I kind of like them as far as cables go, because number one, they're pretty thick. And number two, they don't really like tangle up like other cords or whatever. They don't tangle up too much. So that's one of the reasons why I like them. And like what I was saying, Fostech says that this shorter headphone cable is the one that you can use to drive your portable devices. Good luck with that. If your portable device for listening to music is your smartphone, you're going to need, like I said, a separate amp or amp deck, portable amp deck. If you have a high-res audio player that probably has some their own amplifiers, you can probably get away with it without needing an portable amp deck. So all in all, the build quality of these are really good, really good. And you see all these screws right here? This is for the headband. Everything about these headphones are, that's why they're so heavily modded, because you can replace any part of this headphone that you want to replace. I only replace the ear cups, but you could also, because the headband itself does not bother me. But if you remove these screws right here, you can replace the headband, and you'll see some other mods where they replace the headphones. Or you can add like what they call a custom strap to make the headband more comfortable. I mean everything. They've even replaced these outer shells right here into something else. Some people have modded them with like wooden shells or wood enclosure. Everything is replaceable on these headphones, so you can expect to be owning, if you buy these, you're going to be you can expect to have them for a pretty long time, unless you really mess them up. And that would be really hard to do unless you intentionally want to break or destroy these headphones. Okay, let's talk about comfort and wearability. So out of the box, even without these replacement pads, they're pretty comfortable, so they're okay. But for long listening sessions, it's not gonna be enough. The top part right here, the headband, had just enough padding, and it didn't really bother me too much. So I didn't feel like I needed to buy a comfort strap or replace the headband. The clamping force is decent, but it's I would say like medium to medium light. I have a medium size head, and there was not that much clamping force on this for me. So even for larger heads, it might be good. There, it does have adjustments right here. These adjustable, what do you call these? Adjustable wings, adjustable arms, are pretty good. They can slide into, any kind of position that you can imagine. The only thing is that I don't like with these is, if you're OCD like myself, they don't have any markings. As you can see, they don't have any markings, and they don't they and you and they don't click into place. So they just it's just a smooth sliding system. So that's the only probably negative I don't like about these adjustable arms, is because it's just so smooth and everything. It's hard to figure out what setting you had it on. So when you rewear them after somebody else has borrowed them and wear them, it's kind of difficult to well, not difficult, but it's just a pain in the butt to get them to your head type or head shape again. So that's the only thing with the arms. But I'm sure, like I said, these Fostex are so moddable and everything's replaceable. Someone probably already figured out how to put markings or make these click into place, or even probably replace these arms, these adjustable arms.
As they are out of the box, as you can see right here when I unboxed them, the headband never really bothered me. That's why I never got a replacement headband or a comfort strap. But the padding on the ear pads did somewhat bother me for longer listening sessions. They were okay, but not the best. So I'm gonna say this again and again. Get replacement ear pads because the stock ones are not as comfortable. They don't have to be as expensive as the Diconi ones right here, which I ended up not really using as much. And these are around almost $50. They can be something simple like my Sensen ear pads, which are really good and comfortable ear pads, which didn't really change the sound signature too much, and those were $13. Or you can go with the Brainwaves, which is like in between the most expensive and least expensive, and the Brainwaves go for around $20 with shipping and handling, or $21 on Amazon with Prime Free Day delivery, and you'll get the best of both worlds. You'll get the comfort, and to me, you get the better looks with these ear pads. And most importantly, they don't change the sound. So you can go online, find the best ear pads for your budget, or you can see my review on the different ear pads that I tried out for these Fostex, and any one of them will do better than the stock ear pads. And with them, you're going to get the best comfort and wearability. I mean, with the Brainwaves and the Sensen and the Deconis, you're probably, with them on, you're going to get the best comfort out of any headphones. So like with my Brainwaves or the Sensen or the Deconi, they're right up there with some of the most comfortable headphones that I have for wearing and comfort. And that's for like long extended wearing sessions over 2 hours or more. So you're going to get the best in comfort and also get a better sound out of the replacement ear pads. And you'll also get better looking ear pads that will make your headphones look better. All right. Connectivity is real easy. All you do is get the headphone adapt or headphone cable of your choice, and then plug them into your device. Although, like I said, if we consider connectivity to mean like it could connect to any device and be driven, then no. Like I said, you will need a separate amp DAC or a high resolution audio player that has good amps inside of them. And just like what I was saying in my unboxing, if you don't like the stock cables that it comes with, you can get your own. Like, these are the cables. This is the cable that came with my Soundcore Life Q20, and it fits in here no problem, as you can hear that snap into place. So you will have no issues. I know a lot of people that own the T50s buy the Vmoda braided cables because they also come in different colors, and the, you know, Vmoda makes some quality products too. Just be aware that most others or other cables are either usually straight or they have an L shape and a straight and not the two L shaped ends like the Fostex has here. And they won't have the locking, these locking, what do you call these? Like knobs, locking knobs. So just be aware of that. So the good thing with these, because they lock into place, is that you're not gonna accidentally, like, get, if you get this caught into something, they're gonna just, you know, get disconnected. Whereas if you get an aftermarket cable like this one, and I accidentally snag it onto something, this can get connected, but it's gonna have to take a lot of force to pull that. You guys seen how much force I have to use to pop this out of place? In that case, I'm probably thinking, if you ever get the wires caught up onto something, see, like this regular cable is already can get tangled up. This one never gets tangled up.
And that's probably why people get the V-Moda cables, because braided cables usually don't get tangled. So that is that with connectivity. Okay, so now that brings us up to our final section. Finally. Right, and that is the sound. We're going to go over the sound in detail. So first off, like I said previously, the three types of RP headphones, the T20 being the bassiest, it is. And I definitely recommend these if you're a bass head like me. With that being said, the bass on these headphones, at least based on my ears, and when I use a, because I usually use a amp DAC, or my I prefer listening to these Fostech headphones with either my Pioneer high-res audio player that I just reviewed, or I use it with the Pioneer and an amp DAC. Usually not this DAC, but I prefer using the Monolith DAC. And if you guys want to know why, you'll see in my Monolith and Empire review. Only because they offer, the Monolith offers a wider soundstage. And we'll talk about soundstage in a little bit. But getting back to the bass on these headphones is very good. And it's very clear. It's not a muddy type of bass. And the bass usually, and I mean usually, it doesn't interfere with your mid-range and your highs, or doesn't interfere with the vocals and the treble. And so for listening to like hip-hop and dance music, I usually pick these up. Has these Fostechs replaced my current favorite for listening to music, and that's the Audio Technicas right here that I got special ear pads for. Depends. I still prefer the Audio Technicas on certain tracks like vocals, or tracks like slow ballads, slow songs, or live music, concert type music. I prefer the Audio Technicas, and the Audio Technicas also go into that sub bass a little bit deeper than the Fostechs, but the Fostechs will win over the Audio Technicas when it comes to pure bass, or more bass and pure bass. And like, they're very similar in that the bass on both of these headphones are very clear, and they don't interfere with the other parts of the sound, like your trebles and your mids. But this is more better when it comes to bringing out vocals than the Fostechs. But man, it's pretty hard to decide which I like better as far as like for listening to music, because it just depends. So normally with the Fostechs, to get better sound, I'll use the Empire amp with either my Pioneer high-res audio player, or I can use the Fostechs with the V35. And this amp DAC right here, the Empire. But the Fostechs, I prefer listening to them with the Pioneer and the my Monolith amp DAC. Now soundstage, these are open headphones, so you would think they would have more soundstage. But believe it or not, these Audio Technicas right here have more soundstage. I don't know if it's because of these bass vents right here, or these air holes, or these bass vents that the Audio Technicas have right here on the outside and on the bottom part right here, right there. These are open headphones, but for some reason, I don't feel like they have a wide enough soundstage on their own without the without my Monolith amplifier that the Audio-Technicas do. I mean, Fostech says these are their open headphones and their open back, but the only open part I see is right here on the bottom on these grills. Like, you can kind of see the driver right through there, or even better on this side, you can see the driver, and you can see like a red wire right here on the bottom. But like this part is not, this part right here is not open. So if you wanted to make these more open, I get, or if I wanted to make these more open, I would probably have to unscrew these cups, these headphones, this back, and drill some more holes in here up top where it's not so open. Yeah, I don't think this part is open, as you can see right there. All I see is plastic. So the only open part is this bottom part, which, and so this might be blasphemy to some, but these Civga $93 headphones, wooden headphones, are open back headphones, and these have more soundstage. And if you look, like, you could see the driver right through there, through these grills. See it right there? And compare it to the openings on this and the openings on this. Look how big that is compared to this. Break out my flashlight and let's see if you guys could see right through there. You know what, I have too much light, hold on. Okay, let's check this out. Get my flashlight, you can see it right through there, right? See right through there. Now let's look at the Fostechs. Kind of see it, right? Can you see through there? A little bit. Okay. What about the Audio-Technicas? Not really. Yeah, not really, but you can see those vents right there. You see it? You kind of see the light coming out of there, as you can see, on these bass vents. I don't know if my flashlight is even bright enough, and you could kind of see right there. Kind of, right? So yeah, for being an open back headphone, the soundstage is not as big as I expected. And like I said, out of these three headphones that I'm currently listening to as my favorites, and yes, I will do a review on these Civgas pretty soon, this has the most open soundstage. And then the Audio-Technicas, actually these are pretty even when it comes to soundstage and mids and highs. And then this is last as far as soundstage, but this has the most bass if you're a bass head. And if you're a bass head, I would still recommend these over the Audio-Technica solid bass and these Civgas right here. Now, soundstage and bass presence, your mids and your your mids and your highs. It's also going to depend on your on the ear pads that you use. And if you guys watched my previous videos, I finally settled on these Brainwaves ear pads because they offered to me, at least to me and my ears, the best sound as far as the punchiness in the bass, the openness, the sound stage, and enough mids and highs. And I finally settled on the Brainwaves. These are the large rounds over my white Sinsen angled oval pads. And over my Deconis that I have right here. These are like the most expensive out of the pads that I got. These were like almost $50. And these are their velour pads. But with the velour, it gave it the best, widest sound stage and the best highs and lows. But I was missing a little bit of the punchiness on the bass part on these headphones, on the, at least on the velour, at least to my ears. Which I now use them for my Beyer Dynamic Custom 1 Pros right here. And here are their stock pancake ear pads. Which, like I said, so if you guys are interested in these headphones, any of the Fostex RP series of headphones, they're planar magnetic headphones, the RP line right here, you're going to need to invest anywhere from, like, for me, it was $13 right here on the Sinsen to $21 on these Brainwaves. And all the way up to like almost $50 on these Deconi Elite Velours. And then I didn't even end up using the Deconis as much because I just preferred the sound on these Brainwaves right here. So take that into consideration when you're getting any of the Fostex RP line of headphones. So imaging on these headphones is pretty decent. It's not going to be the best. And the imaging on them is probably next to my other favorite, the Audio-Technicas. They're pretty even in imaging. Imaging and clarity, they're almost the same. I mean, I can hear stuff, especially if you pair these with a good amp or a good amp DAC or a good high-res digital audio player, you're going to get good imaging. Way better than what you would get on a smartphone. And like I said, you cannot drive these on a regular smartphone unless your smartphone has a pretty powerful amp. So every time I get new headphones, I usually go to YouTube and watch the Ultimate Headphone Test, link in the description. And then I'll listen to some other of my favorite tracks. Like right now, for testing out my headphones, my favorite tracks to test them out with is Kendrick Lamar, Love, The Weeknd, I Feel It Coming, and Dr. Dre's Ain't Nothing But a G-Thang. And when I listen to all three of those songs, they do sound real good on these headphones. And as far as imaging go, I can hear little instruments here and there that I don't really hear in other headphones, like say the custom ones. The only one that has just as much imaging and detail is the Audio-Technicas. The Fostex T20 RPs are not high-res certified, as you guys can see in the specs section. But specs don't mean really a damn thing if they don't sound good. And like I said, these sound really good. It's just depends on what you want to listen to them with, what you pair them with to listen to, and what you're listening, what type of music you're listening to. So the treble on these headphones is pretty good. And what I like, you'll kind of know yourself, but I'm kind of treble sensitive. And so certain headphones with a real high frequency response and or, you know, that are more dynamic might be harsher on treble. Like I know on a lot of reviews, people say that some of the Sennheiser, I can't remember if the HD 600X or something like that, HD 800, they're very harsh on the treble. These are not harsh at all on treble. And that's probably because they're not meant to be a treble heavy headphones. I would say my Audio Technicas actually have more treble than the Fostech. But the Fostech's, the treble in the Fostech's T20 RPs are pretty good. And for me, they're good enough. Good enough to where I can listen to a lot of musical tracks on these headphones without me wanting to take off the headphones themselves. I can wear them for hours. Vocals, again, vocals are pretty decent on these headphones. Not the best, but they're not bad. The vocals are a little recessed, but not too badly. So when you're listening to musical tracks with like female voices or female vocals, they might not sound as good as, say, with other headphones that have a better treble response, but it's not bad. So all in all, I would say the sound of these headphones are warm, immersive, and enjoyable. And they're very fun headphones to listen to, especially, like I said, if you're into house or new age, you know, electronic dance music, and also hip hop. These are your headphones to go to. For like opera or, vocals, slow jams, I probably would rather go to the Audio Technicas or even these Sivgas right here, which I will review shortly. So that is it for our sound section in detail. So that is our look at these Fostech T20 RP. MK3s. These are available on Amazon for $159.99. And I don't know if they're available on Fostech's website. I'm going to say no, because I didn't see any links on Fostech's website to suggest, like, you know, how most web pages, it'll say, like, there's this part on the web page where it say buy, and then you click that part and it'll take you to their store. Fostech does not have that. They have one for like to click here for replacement parts and accessories, but nothing for the actual headphones themselves. You can probably also get them anywhere online, Walmart, maybe Best Buy, B&H Photos, whatever. But just remember that if you guys are interested in buying these headphones, whether you get them through my Amazon link or Amazon or anywhere else, you're gonna have to invest in a good amp DAC or amp like what I have here, or maybe you already have one, then you're good to go. Or if you don't want to invest in an amp DAC, maybe you already have a high-res digital audio player like my Pioneer right here. But yeah, regular portable devices like your smartphone. And I'm even going to say, even with my LG V35, I don't know about the newer LG phones with the amp DACs, like the new V60, if it would be powerful enough to drive these headphones at good loud listening volumes. I don't want to say really loud, because, I mean, it's got to be loud enough to, you know, immerse you into the music and enjoy and start to enjoy the music. But to me, with just this phone by itself, it didn't really provide enough volume to where I was really liking the sound, you know. So just be aware of that if you do get any of these Fostech RP line of headphones. So all in all, with the $159 on Amazon, you could probably find it cheaper somewhere else. And then you have to buy ear pads, so let's say these are $20 ear pads and this is a $100 amp DAC. You don't need to get anything more than this. Like, I know I got the Monolith, but this is a $300 amp DAC. And the only reason why I was able to afford this, believe it or not, is because I got it on Target. And Target has the Affirm payment plan. And that was the only way I was able to get this amp DAC. So with replaceable ear pads and amp deck, you're looking at probably almost $200 or a little more than $200 all together in total. And even with that, I would say they're still worth it. They are still worth it as far as that goes, because there is nowhere that you're going to get a planar magnetic headphones for this price. I mean, the next cheapest would probably be the Drop Hi-Fi Man HE4XX, which are around $180, maybe $200 altogether. And even those, you're still going to need an amp deck. Basically, I think those are more efficient, but basically, I think if you're interested in any planar magnetic headphones, you're going to have to invest, unless you already have one, in a decent amp deck. And also, or you already have a high-res digital audio player. But other than that, those are my only stipulations when recommending these headphones. But they are great headphones overall. They sound good. They sound really good. They sound great. And yeah, they are some of my favorites headphones. So basically, if I want to listen to something, depending on what mood I'm in, I'll either pick up these headphones or these. More often than not, you know. So that is pretty much a testament to how good these headphones sound. Because I have other headphones. I have Bluetooth headphones. And if I was on the go, I would probably go with Bluetooth headphones. Or if I was working out, I would go with my Soundcore Liberty 2 Pros for listening to music or going out and about. Just because they don't need to be driven with anything else, so I don't have to carry that many stuff. But if I were to go on vacation and I absolutely had to only pick one headphone, I would either go with this or the Audio-Technicas. And I didn't even go wireless. Because then, if I wanted to go wireless, then I would go with something as small as this and call it a day. So that is about it. If you guys found this review informative or got some value out of it, please like and subscribe. Once again, these are the Fostex T20RP headphones. These are the more bass headphones out of their RP line, regular phase, planar magnetic headphones series of headphones. If you guys are interested in these and you guys have Amazon, please use the link in my description, as it does help out my channel and my charity, the Wounded Warrior Project. Follow me on Instagram at The Workout Geek for all my latest happenings and great workout tips. Until next time, everybody, take care, stay safe, stay healthy, and have a fantastic day.